Hello guys, welcome back to my another video of Linux tutorial. In this video, I am going to show you how to move the file as well as directory from one location to another location through command line interface. So let me show you the syntax of move command. So syntax of move command is similar to copy command, which I had shown you in previous video. Type move mv with option and give source file and the destination where you want to move the file. So move command have two feature. One is to move the file from one location to another location, and other feature is to rename the file and directory. If you want to rename the file name, then we can also use move command. And if you want to move the file from one location to another, then also we use move command. So let me show you the practical. Just type here alias. See here, there is no file and no directory in the current directory. So I will first make one directory with name abc, as well as I will make one file also with file.txt name. So I will type one more time alias. See here, there is one directory with abc name and one file with file.txt name. So I want to move this file, file.txt. So let me enter some data into the file.txt. So type nano file.txt and press enter. I had shown this video nano how to use editor, so you can go and watch that video if you're not familiar with nano command. Just type enter. Now I'm going to write here something. To write into that file, just press Ctrl O, enter, Ctrl S to exit. Now I am doing cat file.txt to see data content is written in that file or not. So it is showing hello. Sorry for this. Here everyone spelling is wrong. Hope also. So sorry for this. So cat file.txt to see the in that file there is data content or not. So it is here. So now I am going to move file.txt into abc.txt. So let me move. Type move hello.file.txt into abc directory. So let me type ls. See here, file.txt did not exist in the current directory. It is moved into the abc directory. I am going to see ls abc to see file.txt. It is showing in abc. It is moved from the current directory to the abc directory. Now I am going to cat abc file.txt. See here, in abc directory there is move file.txt. So I had done cat command to see content is there or not. So see, same file, it is move same file whatever previous in the current directory, it is moved into the abc directory. So if you want to move directory also, the syntax is same for moving the directory. Let me create one directory with dir alias. See, dir exists in the current directory. Now I am going to move this directory into abc directory. Move dir, command is same, abc directory. Give the source file name and destination. I am moving dir directory into abc. Just press enter and type alias. See here, dir directory is no more exist here. Now I will type alias abc to list the abc directory. See here, dir directory move into the abc directory. Let me clear the screen. Type alias. Now you know how to move the file as well as directory into other location. So I am going to show you how to rename the file and directory. See here, abc with abc name, one directory is here. Now I am going to rename this directory. Type move abc, and after that specifying the source what you want to move. Type here what you are going to rename that. I am going to rename with name directory. Just type enter. Type alias. See here, abc directory is renamed with directory name. See here, it is showing directory. If you type ls directory, then it is showing all the data is here, but the directory name is rename here. I have rename. So let me move into the directory. Let's see a file.txt. Now I'm going to see how to rename the file. So just type move file.txt. I'm going to give abc.txt. Press enter. Type ls. See here. Before file.txt, now it is renamed with abc.txt. If you cat abc.txt, the data will be same. What will be the data in file.txt? The data will be same. Only the file name is renamed. So you had seen how to rename as well as how to move the directory and file. Let me clear the screen. So with move command, there is so many option is used, but in this video I am going to show you two option, hyphen I and hyphen F option. Hyphen I option is used to prompt you before overwriting. Let me show you. Type ls, ls directory. Now I am going to copy abc directory to the current directory. Type ls. See here, abc.txt is in exist in current directory, and also ls directory. So abc.txt is exist in current directory as well as in directory also. So if I will move abc to the directory with hyphen I option, press enter. See here, it is prompting me overwrite directory abc.txt. abc.txt which you want to move, it is already exist in the directory. So are you want to move overwrite or not? If you want to overwrite that, then you have to press Y, else press N. No. So I will going to press Y to move. Type ls. See here, abc.txt is no more exist in the current directory. It will be in directory. So abc.txt is moved to the directory name. So the another option is used, hyphen F option. Hyphen F option is used is so do not prompt before overwriting. It is opposite to the hyphen I option. It is prompting you that overwriting, are you want to overwrite or not, file exit at there. So but hyphen F never prompt you, it will always overwrite. So let me copy again abc.txt to the current directory. Type ls. See, abc.txt is now in current directory, and it is also in directory name also, abc.txt. So what I will do, I will move with hyphen F option abc.txt into directory. Just press enter. See here, it is not prompting, and I will type ls, and it is moved into the directory, but it not prompt that it already exist. You want to prompt or not, like hyphen I is doing here. So thank you guys for watching this video. I hope you like this video. If you have any doubt related to this video, you can ask in comment section. Thank you guys. Bye bye.